Hey there, today in the workshop we're going to be taking a look at Mig Jimenez's new line of oil brushers. These are for weathering and decorating models. What this is a replacement, a more modern replacement, for the old-fashioned taking of artist oils, mixing them with mineral spirits, and then weathering a model using that technique. What these does is this already comes pre-thinned and ready to use right out of the bottle. They come in these cool plastic bottles. There's 21 different colors. You can see that they've got all different lines here. I'll name off all the colors here in a minute. And what it is it's like almost like an eyeliner bottle. And it slides out really smooth. And you see it pretty much cleans off the bottle. And then you end up with this super, super thin tip for applying your oils and your weathering to the model. And then removing them as you need to shade. Now, I picked up the entire set of 21. The cheapest place to find these online, because I always like to let you guys know where you can get your model stuff, the least expensive, is direct from MIG themselves so far. I haven't found them available anywhere else. I found them on eBay, but they were at a ridiculous price. It was like $8 a bottle, and that's just insane. You should be able to get the entire set of 21 for around $65 online. And then the stand is optional. The stand runs anywhere if you won't find it anywhere online. It is available at Mig Jimenez directly as well. It's less than 20 bucks for the stand when you get it like that. So, and then you've pulled all 21 colors right at your fingertips, ready to use. I'll go over every single color so that you know what you're getting into, and you can look these up online too. You're going to get buff, sunny flesh, basic flesh, dust, light flesh, dark brown, earth, dark mud, plain white, black, dark blue, ammo yellow, ochre, rust, red primer, medium gray, starship filth, that's a cool name, field green, olive green, dark green, and regular red. Now, those are 21 different colors. Those are pretty much all you're going to need to weather and shadow and shade. Now, what I'm going to do to review these is recently I assembled Bandai's 1/12 scale Shore Trooper from Rogue One. And he needs to be weathered up. He's way too clean as he is assembled out of the box. So I'm going to do a video on using the new oil brushers on weathering Mr. Shore Trooper here. And that'll give my longer time viewers too a chance to see what I've done for weathering and how I get it done with artist oils using this new product that's a lot easier to work with. So let me set up the paint area on the bench and I'll get to work and we'll be back. Hey, so we're back. As you can see, I've detached the Shore Trooper's arm, or his rifle, because I didn't want that to get in the way while we're doing some work here. But I did want to show you how to use the oil brushers, or at least the way I use them. Everybody has their own way of using them. This is one way that I saw done by the actual company themselves, and this tends to work quite well. What I'll do then for the armor here, the first color I want, and this is a multi-step process, so you'll go through everything and do it in your different layers. But what I wanted to do on the first step here was outline it in a dark, like a sand used up color. So I grabbed the ochre, O-C-H-R-E color of the oil brusher. And what you can do is you'll just unscrew it, take it out. Now the brush tip is quite stiff and I will apply it right in here. And I will just gently brush it over. Now I can control this pretty well on his center panel. As you can see, like so. And then we put that away so that we don't have to worry about spilling it. Then, the next step is very important. You let that sit for a little bit on there. Then you take, I like to use these cheap acrylic brushes. You can get these at like Hobby Lobby. But you can use any type of paintbrush you want, but I like the acrylic because they tend to last longer. Use mineral spirits or paint thinner. Now, some plastics will get eaten alive by paint thinner. They'll just get destroyed. So what you always want to do is what I do, whatever kit I'm going to be using, if I'm going to be using oils on it, I take a piece of the sprue and I cut it off and I throw it into the jar of thinner while I'm building. Now, if you reach in and grab that plastic, and it's soft in any way, shape, or form, don't use that thinner on that model. Use a weaker mineral spirits, or, you know, MIG ammo themselves make a very white, nice mineral spirits that won't eat through plastic, and you can use that. But I just use hardware store thinner, about $6 a gallon. And so far it hasn't. It's pretty weak. It's a mineral spirit solution. It's pretty weak. So far it hasn't eaten through any of the styrene. Now you're just going to take the brush and get a little bit of thinner on it. And then just off camera here is just a rag I'm going to wipe it off on. And then you take the thinner and you rub it on there. And then you remove a bunch of it. And I put it on a little heavy so that it shows up on camera. But you can see as you get going, the thinner will start to remove the oils in the high spots and only leave them in the low spots and the recesses that you want to weather. And you'll do small sections at a time. And you'll keep drying off your brush and cleaning it off. And eventually, when you reach the level of weathering that you prefer on that particular part, you will stop. And you can just keep going, and then you're going to take out another color and you're going to blend it. See, now that's where I want to leave that, especially since it's on camera. I want it to show off a little more, but that's a little bit dirty, but not super crazy dirty. But it brings out all those fine lines that were in there and highlights the rest of the detail. So that section there, now to speed up the drying process, you can carefully use a heat gun like I like to do. And you can just continue working on the model. You'll do section by section. Then you can do like a final buff over the whole thing or a final wash over the whole thing to kind of blend everything together. Or you can do it piecemeal. And since it's oils and they take a while to dry, and air dry, you know, they can take up to a day to completely dry, which means you can keep using a little thinner to go in and blend all these different parts. Now, I'm going to continue using different colors. I've got some dust effects, and I use that on the back. You can see how it highlighted those grills. And I'm just going to keep working on them with all the different colors until I'm satisfied. And when we come back, I'll let you guys take a look at what he looks like when I've weathered him using just oil brushers and nothing else. All right, after about an hour's worth of work using Mig Jimenez's oil brushers, the new weathering product out by them, I am done with as far as I want to go with the Shore Trooper. I think he looks absolutely amazing. All the weathering went down really easy. It dried a lot faster than using other types of oils because each time you're custom mixing them with thinner, then you've got to wait for them to dry. These ones dried up pretty darn quick. I'm going to put them on spin mode here so that he can go round and round. I didn't use any other techniques. Now later, of course, off here when I've done this review, I am going to go and do just a little bit of weathering chipping effects on him using some different techniques that I like to use. But this is just where you can get this model so that it looks pretty darn awesome just using the oil brushers and nothing else yet. So you can see, if you didn't want to do any chip effects on him or anything, he's ready to go. He's ready for the shelf. He looks awesome. All the different colors I used in this thing were some of the buff, some of the dust. I used a good amount of the ochre because I wanted to give him that beach sand, that desert look. I used dark mud, black, and the starship filth were my most common colors on this to get them all set up and ready to go for this display. Like I said, it took about an hour. You can see how crisp those lines are on his helmet, done with the oil brushers, and then just gently wiped off with a Q-tip and a little bit of thinner and a little paintbrush. All these little inserts here, because it's an oil paint that actually sticks in, you can see the little details on his helmet, side of his helmet, the vents on his straps, on his stowage, on all the little different compartments, on the straps on his boots, in his calf guards. And then on the pants, of course, I use like a lighter earth color to bring out those high points on the pants. And what I like about the oils, of course, as they dry, they will be a flat tone, so you won't have to coat this. I also did, of course, his chest pieces, his hands. The laser rifle was done with a dust effect of the oil brushers and then wiped off heavily just so it was in the low parts. Being a Shore Trooper, he's going to get everything all dusty and dirty. So, and in the movie, you know, these guys definitely were not as clean as a regular Stormtrooper in the white-black motif. These guys had actually seen more action and had actually been through a lot more dirtier situations. So I love how it turned out. If you want to see me build this figure, go ahead and go to the review of the Bandai Shore Trooper, which of course I'll get to show you how to build it. But other than that, these oil brushers, top notch. I'd highly recommend them. Go look them up. I'll put a link to the Ammo American website, the USA website. Otherwise, if you live in another country, you can always get them direct from their home country of Spain. Thanks for watching my review of these oil brushers by Ammo Mig Jimenez. We'll see you at the next review.